Has everybody got their glasses, well, charged? It's too late if you haven't. When Daniel asked me to do this presentation, he said, you've got 10 years to cover. So I sat down and I got it down to an hour and a half. Then Daniel rang me back and said I had 5 minutes. So the only way that I could do it was to put it on one of these so that I don't have to talk. So that should get it done in record time. So we've just hit what we call a very successful decade. There is no doubt about that. We have wonderful achievements. We have a tremendous increase in quality and number of referees, and we're over 200. And the great acknowledgement from the VBRA and Knox and others were our accolades. You're right. I can work it, but I'm not controlling it. Come on. Recruitment was the key that we had to look at. The Knox competition was expanding and we needed referees. We needed to develop those referees so that they were able to handle the games as they come in from all different age groups and also the senior domestic competition as well. Training became a major focus for the entire decade. The acknowledgement of that training was above and beyond what we had expected. And we all took a great pride in the rewards that we came our way. The executive appointments, the retirement of Fred Jago, and I just couldn't think of any other word but a legend. Ken Andrews, 2000-2008, a great administrator, took over. And it was seamless. The continued excellent service of Horse Ferris. I think Horse has still got the first dollar that we ever collected. I'm sure he has. And when he took over, I think we were about $154 in the red. And I think today we've got probably $30,000 in the bank. The retirement of Bev Agenbauer after 25 years as a Saturday supervisor. A very joyous day, but a sad one. And the joy of the man standing or sitting here in the room tonight is that Daniel Batty took over as Saturday supervisor and has been since then. The advisor appointments was Neil Black, Black was 1999-02, and then Anthony Allsbrook was appointed in 03 and is currently still holding the role. And a marvellous job from Anthony. We had one person who, during the 02-03 period, who came back and ran some schools for us because we needed more people. And I used to go in at the start of the school and I used to introduce him as the best referee that the association had ever produced. And he was just back from overseas appointment. Where was he? Do we know who it is? Chris Ray. There he is, that one. Chris Ray. He came back and helped us out while before we got Anthony. Right, we started what was called the Girl Power Squad. And it is politically correct to do that. They wore purple shorts, no shirts, and black shorts. We received a 10,000 grant from the state government for women in sport, and the coffers were full, and we could afford to do all sorts of things like buying cameras. One got nicked. We got a recorder. We got all sorts of things, and it certainly assisted us right across the board with our development. The girls, as referees was extremely successful, and the girls took pride in wearing those purple shorts. Cheers. It'd be really boring if I didn't use up the lab. The establishment of the development squad for males and females, which was our grey shirts. And that took off because suddenly referees were being acknowledged. They wore the shirts in the domestic and junior competitions, and they had pride of place. When someone in a grey shirt came out to do a game, it was acknowledged that they were the best referees that we had. And they did an absolute magnificent job, and it was a pathway for all referees, training and promotion. And at that time, the Victorian Junior panel, we had to give up referees for the Friday nights and that, and our Saturday commitment to Victorian basketball, we honoured with pride. The VBRA annual awards. And with the work that went on behind the scenes from an incredible team of people who worked above and beyond what was asked of them. We were acknowledged as the best referees program during 1999 to 2008. 2000, 2005, 2006, 2007, 2008. The best in Victoria, and it is an absolute wonderful achievement. Not basketball. The president used to sit on the Knox basketball board meetings, and during that time we got a voting position on the Knox board and have held it since then. The support from Knox continues to this day, and without Knox, we wouldn't be here, but in the same state without our sponsor, it was a wonderful thing to be able to go to a Knox board and ask them for things, and they would go and say yes. And that support from behind the scenes will never be known about how strong it was, but it certainly laid the foundation for today. They go to pay rates and they go to supervisions of all sessions support. They actually pay for us to do a job. And with that support, we were able to give people a remuneration that was fair. And instead of them just walking up and down in the court, supervising three courts or six courts or wherever, they weren't given $3 and $4. They were given the A grade pay rate, which was an enormous increase for Knox at that time, but they made a decision that they either had to get behind the referees or they wouldn't have referees for each of the games. And the gentleman said tonight, we put two referees on every single game of 500 games of basketball, every single week, which is a tremendous achievement. 2005 saw the introduction of the referee levy, and it was a dollar from each pay packet for the development and training of referees and associated costs. And that's probably where the strength of the branch started. We had money for development, we had money for referees who went away to games, to be appointed to tournaments and those sorts of things, and we helped them with their costs. So they went away with pride, and they went away first class. It was a very successful decade. We had wonderful achievements. We had a tremendous increase in quality and the number of referees, over 200 of them, and hadn't been seen before. And now we're up to 340, which is fantastic. The great margin from the VBRA, winning all the awards, and Knox. Knox basketball, a wonderful support of the referees without a doubt. And others who we thank them for that support and acknowledgement. And the decade of 1999